What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another video, and in this one I'm going to be going over what I think is one of the biggest sleeper routes in the game. And yes, I'm in gun bunch, but the route is also in other formations. I'll go over that a little bit later, but the play is Y curl, and the route in particular is the Michael Thomas route. Now, this route is very similar to, like, obviously dig HB out. It's been a very popular play this year. It's similar to that route in the sense that it gets very good inside positioning. It's not a post route, but it's mainly, it's like a delayed seam streak route, and zones just do a very poor job of covering it. And I'll go ahead and show you guys that throughout this play in this video. And so the only adjustment I make, because I'm kind of OCD, is I go ahead and streak Coleman, just because that wheel route's just weird for me. But mainly you're going to be looking for Thomas on this play. And what I like to do is go ahead and throw an inside pass lead low ball. So it's almost like you're almost getting the same type of positioning on, like, this pass as you would with a post route, since you're low passing it and you have an inside pass lead. So you're leading him more towards the middle of the field, which is the same area that, like, a typical post route is going to be attacking. Right here against Tampa 2, I didn't even have to low ball this. Against Tampa 2, you really don't have to low ball. I just did it for demonstration's sake, because you can go ahead, get inside, and possession catch it. But against stuff like cover 3 and cover 4, I usually will low ball just so that I don't take a huge hit and you can go ahead and get a nice possession catch. You don't have to worry about, you know, them jarring the ball loose or what have you. So right there, low ball, and Drew Brees made a rare bad throw. But you can see why I would want to do that, because against cover 4, especially if you're playing mutt, this is Regs and Harrison Smith is right there. So you got 91 zone right here against cover 4 once again. And that's really what you're looking for right there. So you avoid the big hit from Harrison Smith and Regs. And then obviously mutt, everybody's going to have 91 zone and big hitters at safety. So you just don't want to take that huge hit. And this route, as you can see, just like not really any zones do a great job of guarding it. I'm going up against random zone defenses right now, a lot of cover 2 and cover 4, it seems like. But even cover 3 doesn't do a great job. Once again, cover 4, and Drew makes another uncharacteristically bad throw. So I'll go ahead and show you guys this route against cover 3 real quick. And I generally like, for a receiver, in this case I have Michael Thomas out there, I like them not to have 91 route running, because I think that the route is a little bit better the more delayed it gets, because the more delayed it is, the further away zones drift from it, and then it gives it more space to work with. Also, we can go ahead and talk about how it's a crime that Michael Thomas doesn't have 91 route running as a Saints fan, and how good he's been over the past 2 years. That's just, like, mind-blowing to me, but I don't know how he hasn't gotten that threshold yet, but that's another conversation. But right here, we're going to go up against cover 3 sky, and really it's the same story. You can go ahead, low ball it, see how the safety drifts back. Against cover 3, it's a little more sketchy. That's Sendejo, so that's not 91 zone Harrison Smith. That hook curl does a little bit of a better job of playing it, but then you also have the underneath drag route. So you kind of put that hook curl in a one-on-one scenario. You don't have to tunnel on the Michael Thomas route on this play. You just read between that hook curl and the underneath drag along with Michael Thomas. And, you know, make the decision that you think is best. So right there, once again, low pass. And even if that was Harrison Smith right there, I'll go ahead and show you guys. He still shouldn't be able to make that play. But if you're not comfortable throwing that ball against cover 3 against someone with 91 zone in the middle of the field, then I would just go ahead and say check it down, take what the defense gives you, and go ahead and take the underneath drag route if your opponent's not using it. So the user defender definitely adds another level to this play. And this is a very base setup. You can definitely do something with, like, Josh Hill on that little curl route. That's not really useful, so you might be able to find a better route for him to go on to make this play a little bit better. You also have Kamara going out to the flat, so if they don't have hard flats out there, you can hit that almost every single time. But right here, we're going to go ahead and try and show one more time. Low pass, and that, in that case, is Harrison Smith coming down off of that deep third, and he's still not able to get there. So as you can see, cover 2, cover 3, and cover 4, this route is going to be effective every single time. Cover 2, you don't have to low ball it. Cover 3 and 4, I feel more comfortable low balling it. And then on top of that, even if you don't want to tunnel on the route entirely, you still have the underneath drag route coming down by Ted Ginn right there, taking easy 9 yards. He gets lit up by Barr and fumbles, of course, but you get the concept. Nice high-low. And like I said, I think this is one of the most slept on routes in the game. I think it's been very good, and right there Harrison Smith was able to make a nice play and jar the ball loose. But it's also in other formations as well. You have this in gun bunch. You have one in a gun empty bunch as well, which is a bunch variant, obviously. You also have it in gun wing pair, I believe it is. They have a play, I think it's like jet six drive, where that route is on it. You also have it in, I believe it might be a gun wide trips. It's a trips formation out of gun, and it's pretty rare. But that play also has that route. So it's in a few different playbooks. You just kind of have to go looking for it. It might not be in the playbook that you're using. It's kind of a rare route, but I think it is very, very good when used in the right scenarios, and it kind of forces your opponent to have to respect it and at least be in the area with his user defender to at least throw off your timing. Because if he just lets you go throw this route on time, on rhythm every single play, it's going to be a problem and you're going to have a lot of success. So that's going to be it for this video, guys. As always, I hope you enjoyed. Definitely comment. Let me know what you think are some of the biggest sleeper routes that you think are in Madden 18. I'd be definitely interested in hearing your input on that. This was Y Curl. I think you'll definitely be seeing more about this play coming up, because I do think it's a very versatile play, and I think you can definitely dig into different setups. But as always, guys, thank you so much for watching the video, and until next time, take it easy.